Hello, Earth citizens. In this video, I will show you how to do a 10-minute routine for your second chakra. First of all, your second chakra is located 2 inches below your belly button, and imagine 2 inches inside, in the center of your body. In brain education, the second chakra is a bright red color, like this. So someone with a healthy second chakra have a lot of creative energy. They also have good relationships with themselves and good relationships with others. While someone with unhealthy energy in their second chakra might experience low levels of energy, low drive, some issues with their sex life, some issues with their own relationships with themselves and relationships with others. So typically people who hold a lot of grudges, hold a lot of resentment, hold a lot of regrets, emotions that affect relationships with themselves and other people, have some issues in their second chakra. So in this video, I'm gonna show you some exercises to release some stuck and heavy energy that may be in your second chakra. Okay, so we're gonna start by lying down on the floor. Okay, so lie down on the floor. With your knees bent like this, feet flat on the floor, feet shoulder width apart. If you can see, my feet are not together, my feet are shoulder width apart. Arms by your side, palms facing upward, and we're going to gently bounce your sacrum area like this. The sacrum is a very important place to help open up your second chakra. A lot of the times, because we sit down for a long period of time, this area is blocked. If the back side is blocked, the front side is blocked, and everything is blocked. So we're gonna start by lightly tapping your sacrum. You can close your eyes if it helps you focus on your body better, if it helps you feel your body better. Relax your sacrum, relax your pelvis, bounce. Let's bounce 50 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Feel your sacrum and tailbone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. Stop. Drop your knees to one side, face the other way, twist your lower back. As you twist your lower back, breathe. Now switch. Drop your knees to the other side, look the other way, twist and breathe. Feel the deep stretch in your lower back. One more time, switch. As you exhale, imagine all the heavy energy in your sacrum releasing out through your breath. One more time, switch. Okay, return to center. We're going to do the same thing again 50 times. This time, try to feel if there's even a slight difference this round compared to the first round, okay? All right, relax your hips, relax your sacrum, tap. Keep your feet shoulder width apart, flat on the floor, 50 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. Great job. Stay here. Can you feel some tingling sensation coming from your tailbone and sacrum out to your hands, out to your abdomen, out to other parts of your body? Maybe you can feel some heat forming in that area. Focus on that area and try to feel any kind of heat, magnetism, tingling sensation there. Breathe deeply into your lower belly. Now breathe in through your nose. Exhale out, drop your knees to one side and look the other way. Exhale, relax your whole body. Breathe into your lower belly. Exhale, return, switch. Other direction. Inhale. Exhale, return one more time, drop. Return, switch. Okay, return to center. Now slowly turn your body to the left side and sit up, please. As a note, that's a very good exercise to do for women who get menstrual cramps. If you loosen up that sacrum area by doing tapping against the floor, it will really help you circulate energy that is causing menstrual cramps. All right, now let's continue. Place your hands on your knees. We're going to rotate our waist, okay? So drop, stretch as far down as you can into the side and back. Feel the rotation in your waist. One, two. You should feel the stretching in all angles of the circle. Three, four, make sure you are breathing. And five, rotate other direction. One, two, three. Can you feel your waist? Stretch deeply. Four. Last one. And five. Okay, great job. Now twist. Twist from your midsection. Breathe. Great job, and stop. Now let's tap the front side of our abdomen. Make your hands into a fist. And seal the top of your fist with your thumbs. With your pinky side, I want you to tap that second chakra area 2 inches below your navel. And imagine you are tapping through the skin into the center of your body. Like this. Relax your shoulders. No tapping like this. Relax your shoulders. You can close your eyes too. Straighten your spine. Tuck your chin slightly inward. And touch the tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth. As you tap here, bring your mind, your awareness to the center of your body. The area that you're tapping, focus your attention right in that center point. Let's tap here for 1 minute. For 1 minute, totally focus your mind to the center of your body, your second chakra. As you tap here, relax parts of your body that you feel are tight. For example, your shoulders, your arms, chest, even your gut. You might find yourself tensing your gut area when you tap. Relax that area so energy can move more freely. The benefit of tapping here is to release stagnant energy that is in your gut area. And also, by focusing on the center of your body, you are bringing your energy down here. Where the mind goes, energy follows. And where energy follows, it accumulates. 30 more seconds. Don't forget to breathe. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Stop. Massage your abdomen clockwise. Slowly open your eyes. How do you feel? Do you feel some tingling, subtle tingling sensation in your body, particularly your core area and maybe your hands too? If you're very sensitive to energy, you might still feel some tingling on the backside from the tapping that we did earlier. Of course, 10 minutes is not very long, so I recommend doing this routine again to feel even deeper benefits, even deeper awakenings. A lot of us hold a lot of tension here for many different reasons, from sitting down, from emotional components, from diet, so many things that cause this second chakra midsection area to be blocked. So I recommend doing this again so that you can keep opening deeper. You did a great job. To experience a full 1 hour brain education based class, please visit a local body and brain yoga studio near you.